Paul in Woodinville, Washington. Hey, Paul, what's on your mind today?
Hey, Tom. You know, I, as interesting as your conversation with Reverend Bill,
Keller. Yeah.
Was actually it wasn't all that interesting. It was entertaining to some degree, but not very interesting, honestly. I'm sorry.
That's quite all right.
let me tell you why. Because it seems to me that every time one of these shootings happens, actually I can't say every time because that would mean 350 plus times a year. We only talk about the high profile, many, many people killed or wounded. But this is another example, since the San Bernardino is an example of where the right wing and the ammosexual gun huggers are successful in changing the subject.
Ammosexual?
Ammosexual gun hugger.
What a great word. Did you invent that?
No, I can't say. I put the two together. I must say, I've heard both of them, but I thought ammosexual should modify gun hugger.
Ammosexual gun hugger. I love it.
but I can't take credit for inventing it. I can take credit for marketing the putting the two together.
Which you've done very well. So your point is that when the shooting happens, they want to change the subject and talk about something else.
Well, what we talk about in this case, it's terrorism. Oh, it's Islamic terrorism.
Right.
Last week when it was, or 2 weeks ago when it was the Colorado Springs shooting, now they want to talk about mental health.
Yeah.
When it's a school shooting, there should be guns in the hands of every teacher. And so we never get down to and I have to say, I'm willing, you could have conceded everything that Bill Keller said and said, okay, Bill, good. Now what are you going to do about it? I mean, what is this giant abstract war on Islam going to do, and all the troops, you know, boots on the ground in Iraq and Syria, how would that have prevented, and they love to use this, how would that have prevented the shooting in San Bernardino? Not.
Right.
Or the one in Colorado Springs, or the one in Newtown, or the one in Aurora, Colorado, or on and on and on. How would, because it comes back to guns.
Yeah,
and I got to tell you, they want to say it's not guns, but I'm willing to bet that the 30 people wounded in the last two shootings of San Bernardino and in Colorado Springs could well speak for the dead when they say it's the bullets coming from guns that are causing all the misery.
Well, I think that it's almost, you know, there are times when I almost wonder, you know, is the universe talking to us or is God talking to us? You'll recall. After the Sandy Hook shooting, the massacre. In fact, it was the same day, as I recall. There was a guy in Beijing, China, who went nuts in a classroom full of kids, and with a knife, and he wounded some 30 children, but he did not kill anybody successfully, and because they have gun control there, and so this time we get a mass shooting in San Bernardino, and the next day or a couple days later, whenever it was, in the UK. You get a guy who goes, oh, this is for Syria, and he's got a knife, right? And he wounds three people. He didn't kill anybody. If the guy in China or if the guy in London had had a semi-automatic weapon of war, there would be, there'd be a bunch of dead children and teachers, and there would be a bunch of dead commuters. And instead, some blood was drawn, and that was it. And isn't it's like the coincidence of timing is just freaky, Paul.
It is, and let me, because we have to move on, share with you information. As you may know, I've told you that my issue now is firearm liability insurance.
Right.
That's something we've been talking about, and I've been working on it here in Washington State, and here, let me share what I've come up with.
Okay.
I've met with some legislators, and they've been receptive to listening to me, but one in particular said, Paul, listen, I think you, and this is for everybody who, I think this is the key piece of legislation and the implications you can discuss about how it would help in a lot of ways. But he said, I think you're wasting your time, he said it in a nice way, sitting down talking to legislators, because the Republicans will not budge on a single thing. And he said, they just won't. They will stymie it. So what you have to do is you have to take this to a citizens initiative, through citizens initiative, get it on the ballot. And to remind people, here in Washington State, 2014, we passed a close the gun show loophole background check by 64%. And that was on an off year, 2014.
Wow.
Okay, so his suggestion was, get this on an initiative and do it on a high turnout year like the presidential election, which is 2016 or 2020, and that way you can get it. Because most normal people agree that why shouldn't you have liability insurance? You got to have it on your car.
Right, and your home, by the way. You can't get a mortgage if you don't have liability insurance.
Right. So these are things, this is the way we have to approach the problem. And with liability insurance, I mean, you can talk about all of the aspects of insurance. The one thing I talk about in terms of people is the NRA is a lobby group. They're a lobby for the gun manufacturers and the retail sellers. And the way to check them down is not with government. It's with another free market force, and the insurance industry is the one to do that.
Yeah, I'm with you. You know, the song I've been singing for years is the treat guns like cars. You have to be licensed. You have to prove proficiency. You have to have liability insurance, and the machine itself has to have a serial number that is registered at the time of manufacture, and that registration is a continuous.
It doesn't have to be with the government, with your insurance company, and just like your credit cards. So people can't go from one insurance company to the other stockpiling guns. You know, I registered this with Geico, this one with Farmers. Is that it goes into just like your you know, if you take out credit cards, it goes into your credit report.
Right. A national pool of information.
See, oh, I see you have you can insure a gun with us, but I see you have one registered with Geico or insured by Geico too. So your insurance rates are going to go up if you start buying gun after gun. The insurance industry will decide, you know what, you're starting to look like kind of a big risk, maybe a high payout. And right. That's the way they're going to. That's the way another industry, a free market industry, can regulate.
NRA. And isn't it amazing that, you know, because in with regard to homes, you don't by law have to have liability insurance. You're just dumb if you don't. But the banks got together and said, we don't want to be on the hook. We don't want people, you know, having, you know, somebody slips and falls in their house and sues them for $1 million. They won't be able to pay their mortgage anymore, and we end up with a house. So we're going to require people to have liability insurance before we'll issue a mortgage. And that's, you know, there's your, quote, free market example. So, yeah, I'm with you, Paul. I think it's brilliant. It's brilliant. Keep up the good work. To watch more clips from our programs, hit the Watch More Videos button over here. And please be sure to hit the handy-dandy subscribe button so you'll always be up to date. Tag, you're it.